Russian President Vladimir Putin says operations by Israeli Air Force in Syria are in breach of Syrian sovereignty. Now, Putin made this remark in a phone call with Israeli Premier Benjamin Netanyahu after a Russian plane was accidentally downed by Syrian fire over Latakia. He said the incident happened because Russian-Israeli agreements on the prevention of dangerous incidents were not observed. Netanyahu expressed regret over the incident, offering all necessary information for investigations. Now, Moscow has accused Tel Aviv of indirectly causing the Russian plane to be shot down. Joining us now out of South Bend is E. Michael Jones, editor at Culture Wars Online magazine. Hello, Mr. Jones. This could, you know, really escalate into something nobody wants to see. Your thoughts?
Well, that's why they have an agreement, so that it doesn't escalate. Now, whether it was accidental or not, I mean, who knows? Maybe it was intentional. But the fact of the matter is that Israel has carried out 200 airstrikes against what Iranian positions in Syria. They feel they can do this with impunity, and Syria needs to, at this point, seal the airspace. If they can't seal the airspace, they are not a sovereign country. Now, what are the consequences here? If they don't do it, if Russia doesn't do it, then the United States is going to call Vladimir Putin's bluff, because in March he announced that they had these missiles that were going to strike anywhere and protect Russia. Well, do they have the missiles or not? Okay, if they have the missiles, if they have the S-500, whatever they're calling them, they need to put them in place now, and they need to start shooting down planes that violate Syria's airspace. That's the only way this war is going to come to the end, and that's the only thing that Israel understands. The context, the incident, or what we need to keep in mind here, is what happened when Israel invaded Lebanon in 2006. They sent their tanks across the border, and Hezbollah stopped them within 500 yards of the border because they had missiles that made those tanks obsolete. If that's the only thing that Israel understands, something like that is going to have to happen now with Syrian airspace.
Thank you for joining us and with your perspective, Mr. E. Michael Jones, editor of Culture Wars Online magazine, joining us out of South Bend, Oregon.